Shalom, shalom. Let's start off by giving all praises, honors, and glories unto Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Makakwadash, double honors to the apostles and the elders of the church of Great Millstone. Shalom to the sincere, hopeful elect, you brothers out there prophesying in the true name, in the true doctrine about the times we're in, headed to, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. My name is Kwadash Paya. Real quick, you know, just a quick update, certain, you know, prophetic events going on. You know, I've been, you know, tied up due to the situation I'm in, but through the Spirit of the Lord, man, you know, it's going to get better. But, you know, as watchmen, we watch and pray, and seeing the times we're living in and filter it through the scriptures. You know what I'm saying? And you got a lot going on, man. You know, you got over here this article where it says massive amounts of dead fish mysteriously appear worldwide. Is it Hosea's prophecy? And they were naming different countries like Mexico, certain places in China, you know, globally, how they just washing up on shore. You know, these things, you always had, like, you know what I mean, water pollution, oil spills and things like that. You know, but scriptures in Hosea speaks about the birds dying, the sea animals dying. You know, and this is in a global scale. You know, everything that's happening now is on a global scale. Then you got the conflict with what it says, war drums, as cyber experts warn that Russia will strike the U.S. with cyber attack if sanctioned. You know, and the whole conflict with NATO and wanting Ukraine to join NATO, but Russia's like, nah, we ain't having that. They, you know what I mean? And so NATO has been putting their forces on the borders of Russia, so Russia is now putting some of their forces around Venezuela, Cuba, on America's borders. Like, yo, like, you putting your troops on our borders, so how you like if we put our troops on your borders? You know, so there's a lot of shoulder rubs right now. And then you have them speaking about cyber attacks, you know, and not too long ago you just had American news articles stating that, you know, there's extremists that plan on having cyber attacks. So It's you got to read between the lines of the narratives that's trying to be put out, but it could be cyber attacks for a reset for the a currency. It could be different reasons, you know, but at the end of the day, remember, there was darkness in the land of Egypt, you know. There was darkness is coming, man. You know, evil times is coming. You know, these are the times that we're living in. You know, hearing about wars and rumors of wars, right? And A, like the scriptures in Revelation 11th chapter, where it states what? Two woes are past and a third woe cometh quickly, roughly paraphrasing. So that last third woe, war, global war, a global nuclear war is coming, is occurring quicker in a comparison of the time frame of World War One in between to World War Two. Until now, you see, and, you know, there's a lot of digital currencies, talks, you know, of a global currency, you know, and that friction between America and China with the conflict over there in Taiwan. And not only that, you have also over here, pardon me, right here, I'm not going to play the video. This is on Google, though, which says chance of, you know, DTA, you could read it, in Tehran as protest against Saudi. You know, Saudi Arabia's allies with America. And Tehran is over there in Iran. You know, so, and there's friction between Iran and Israel. Israel go to war. That's, you know, if Israel strike, because America's been trying to go in Iran, so that's, like it says you in Zephaniah 3, I believe verse 8 or 9, it says, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, till I gather the nations. He said, my determination is to gather the nations. to pour upon them mine indignation, which is righteous judgment. So the Lord is gathering these nations over there in the Middle East. You know? Armageddon, man. Armageddon in the Hebrew. Which is what? Mountain of troops. You know, all these troops. Like the scriptures say, let the weak say I am strong. You got, I believe, North or South, one of those two, Korea, where they're having these practice missile strikes. So, we in them times, man. You know, RT News, peace with U.S. only possible after New World Order. Putin ally, and you got a lot of different NATO members, you know, different countries, European countries of NATO that's backing out of this, you know, Ukraine conflict between Russia. You see, and that, hey, listen, that's a house divided against itself. You know, that's a house divided against, and the scriptures speak about a house being divided, it's not going to stand. You know, all this that they're trying to accomplish will not be accomplished. You know, America, aka Babylon the Great, is falling, man. It's falling. It definitely is crumbling from the inside out like Rome. You know, and America's fashioned by Rome, Greece, Egypt, ancient Babylon, you know, so on and so forth. A new world order, you know? And you see, with the whole pipelines, the gas deals, which says red alert. Where was it? How Putin's $11 billion pipeline split NATO and the EU at a time of crisis. So, you know, that's heavy. You know, because America don't. They get their oil and stuff. You know, overseas, Venezuela, things like that, which I heard they got their own refineries now, but I mean, we'll see how long that lasts, you know, but it's all about war. Right now we at war. You know, like the scriptures say, there's a time and there's a season for everything. We in a season and time of war. You know? That's the time we're in, because in order for the kingdom to be established, you know, on earth, these wicked kingdoms and these kings that's ruling on the earth now is going to be destroyed. America, aka Babylon the Great, is going to be completely destroyed, the lake of fire. This is why Yahweh Shah is referred to as what? The King of Kings. Even though we're kings, you know, but what? We're going to take the kingdom. We're going to take the kingdom. We're not going to ask for it. How you think this kingdom, all these kingdoms, was established? By war. By robbery. You know? By lies. Treaties. Sanctions. Death. Witchcraft. Sorcery. You know? And the Lord's clock is ticking. We had, you know, time is speeding up. The doomsday. Doomsday clock. But the Lord's clock is what? The solar. The moon. The chariots popping up. Prophecies. You know? Like the Lord told Ezra, measure thou the times diligently. You know, because it's all manifesting. It's all manifesting for itself now. In this type of intensity, I mean, you can't make that up, bro. Solar and lunar eclipses in 2022. You know, that's the Lord's clock right there, man. You know, the moon shining, you know, in darkness, and it still shines. That's how you know, man. Like, there's the Lord is making all this happen. I think they said there was one that was gonna be in July, if I'm not mistaken. Pardon me, April. They say April 30th. January, March, April, May. Yeah. So they're saying that there's one going to be in April 30th, on May. They say May Day, and October 25th. So they say, you know, but we'll see. You know, those are heavy months too, man. But this is the book of Luke, St. Luke chapter 21 verse 11. And great earthquakes shall be in diverse places. And we are, you know, about all these earthquakes and tsunamis that was recently happening. These different storms, wildfires, things like that, man. And famines and pestilences. We got the truck strikes, which I believe that's planned. That's set up by design. But nevertheless, everything is orchestrated by the Most High at the end of the day. Like the scriptures say, the deceived and the deceiver is his. He's controlling both sides, right? So people don't understand that it's the Lord that controls the minds of men. Like it says, the king's heart in the book of Proverbs, the king's heart is in the hands of the Lord. So the Lord is directing the minds of these elites and whoever to do what they're doing. He created them. He's the father of all spirits. The earth, everything that's on the earth that has a spirit, that's, it's under the subjection and obedience of Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai. You know what I mean? So there's nothing that could disobey him. Even if somebody thinks they disobeying, they was designed to do that. But anyway, it says, and famines and pestilences. Now you're gonna see some real pestilences occur. Some real shit, some real people dropping dead in front of you type shit. People starving. I believe over there in Haiti, they resulting to cannibalism right now, man. There was some chick on fire. You see this nigga eating her. That's the time. Hey, man, that's some shit that people in America, Babylon the Great, has yet to see. There's not gonna be no virgin daughter no more. There's gonna be things taking place in front of you, traumatic shit, and you still gotta keep moving. But see, knowing these things, man, it's like it prepares you mentally. You go through your trials and tribulations, understanding why these things are occurring. That's why people are bugging out right now, man. You know what I'm saying? Not knowing what to do with their homes, with their families, with they're in panic mode, stocking. But what the men of the Lord, it's like, yeah, we know what's happening. We can see the future. We're seers. We can foresee what's going on. It's already written. Like the scriptures say, that the end is declared from the beginning. That's why we want the end. That's why we want these things to occur, because we know it has to get worse in order for it to be better. Righteously. And fearful sights and great signs shall there be from heaven. So we have people seeing so-called UFOs, which are the angels of the Lord, and they're taking pictures. Oh, what is this? Asking questions. What is? Hey, but look, it tells you in the scriptures. The angels of the Lord. How the Lord cometh with clouds. How he comes with the he's coming with the chariots. No process of elimination, man. What a chariot! A chariot don't fly in the sky. A car is considered a modern day chariot. You got Esau trying to create flying cars, but the chariots of the Lord are in the heavens, man, in the sky. Those are the angels coming to fuck shit up, and at the same time deliver those that fear the Lord, that have faith, and that are sincere. First the brothers, men of the Lord. Then you're gonna have the one third, helpers of the prophets, friends of the prophets. Then you're gonna have women, children. Right? Whoever the Lord sees fit, for salvation when all hell breaks loose. So that's why we gotta pray more now, keep watching. Even if you gotta fast, that goes double into myself. Pray for one another, man. That's one thing we're always, Lord willing, man, if the Lord's dealing with you, you're always gonna have that with you. His name and prayer. Talk to him. Give your supplication. Cry unto him. Because as we're coming to a time we have yet to witness, historically. And this is going to be the last climax. This is going to be the last. That's it. The kingdom of heaven. No more dying. No more death. No more adultery. No more having to be evicted. No more having to work in the morning. No more being ill, bodily ailments. No more none of this shit that we got to go through in this present world. It's never going to happen no more. Because we're never going to go off. That's amazing. You think about that. Sit back and just really think about that. Like, who in their right mind would not want that? And I'll give all this up for that, man. Because everything is going to be destroyed anyway. When Yahweh Shah come back. You know what I mean? Enjoying your family. Enjoying your children. You know? Ruling the earth. Which was created for us. The Israelites. The so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native and Seminole Indians. Which are the biblical Israelites. The 12 tribes. You know? Being at peace with the animals. Scriptures speak about how the children is going to play with lions and bears. Come on, man. You know? Eating righteously. Healthy foods. Having spiritual powers. Immortality. Come on, man. You can't beat that. You can't beat... That's a easy trade-off. Just to... That's... You know? So, but before that, all hell has to break loose. Jacob's trouble has to occur. You know? Great famines, pestilence, families betraying one another. Esau coming with martial law. You know, FEMA camps. You know, fuck it, man. Our forefathers got locked up. Saw how the Lord preserved them. Miraculously. There's nothing impossible with the Lord. You know, if your ways please him, if you have his back, he's going to have your back, man. You know? So anyway, I don't want to keep ranting. I just wanted to bring this out. Lord willing, it was exhorting through the Spirit. You know, you could type in these articles. Type in the title. You know? Go into it. Lord willing, to plant seeds for other brothers to, you know what I'm saying? Bring it out more. But we at the end, man. You know, so with that... Shalom.